السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رمضان كريم and I wish you happy ending of Ramadan as you have been enjoying the happy beginning of Ramadan. We are at the last 10 days of Ramadan, which is the most sacred days of the year, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us with the night of the power, which if we stand and look for it in the last 10 days, we'll be saved from hellfire, no doubt, inshallah. Ameen. Ameen for every and each one of you. Ameen for the people who are listening and the people who are watching and the people who are not listening and not watching. Because our dua and our prayer should not only be for our friends, or for our relatives, or for our neighbors. Our dua and prayer should be for everyone, anyone, everywhere, and anywhere, at any time. And this is the essence of the message of Islam, of the Prophet ﷺ, who came to save humanity, and his message was the everlasting message, and it was the most conclusive message, because it was guided by the Book of Allah, which is a guidance for humanity forever. And he was the teacher for humanity forever. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we make our prayer in Ramadan, we make it for everyone, or even outside Ramadan. Ramadan or outside Ramadan, we should pray for everyone. For every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the climate, for anything. Because we need the blessing of Allah, the blessing of Allah to be showered upon us. We are a very special ummah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why He gave us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was Quran walking on earth. كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His manner was Quranic. His behavior was Quranic. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confessed in His book that وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ رَحْمَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً عَلْمُ. We have sent you Muhammad to be a mercy for humanity, for everybody, for anybody, anytime, anywhere. رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِين. رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِين. رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِين. That's why Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, our Prophet, was a very special, extremely special to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to link his name to the name of Allah in every adhan and every iqamah, in every announcement and every prayer. So how many billion times his name is mentioned day and night? Now if we're in South Africa at 8:30, in UK at 7:30, maybe in America it's 3:30, maybe in Australia is about in the morning, early morning, the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in every corner of the universe, at the vicinity of the creation of the galaxies of Allah, is mentioned continuously, every second, every minute, every hour, because Allah wanted His name to be mentioned, and He made His name to be connected to His name in the adhan and the iqamah. This is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's the only one in whom you make prayer on him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah will respond to you. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallam. Allah and his angels are praying, making salat, salam on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All believers, pray on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. So this is the special status of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another special status of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he was the imam of all the prophets in Jannah when he went in al-Mi'raj to see all the prophets from Adam to Jesus, peace be upon him, that we believe in all of them and we submit our mission to Allah, believing in Muhammad as a messenger and the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and believing in all the messengers and the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was the imam. It's number two. Number three, he was giving the eternal book of wisdom and guidance for humanity, which have the secrets and the essence of life and the life to come. It talks about many things and not everything, but and open the gates for thinking and discovering and contemplating about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at yourself in the mirror and see the beauty of the touch of Allah on your heart and your body and how He created you and me. So you give Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he guaranteed that his book, Al-Quran, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرُ وَإِنَّا لَحْنُ nobody will be able to change a word of the Quran. We, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نَحْنُ revealed الذِّكْر, Al-Quran, وَإِنَّا Allah لَهُ protecting its existence. No one will be able to change it, no matter what they say about it, no matter what they make different explanation and wrong explanation and dubious explanation, but Allah will preserve it. You know where? In the hearts of the believers. In the hearts of the believers. In the hearts of the believers. So you will have the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we have Ramadan, which is a whole month of forgiveness, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chained the mighty devils in this month, and He did not want them to distract you in this month. This is how Allah loves each and every one of you, each and every one of us. He loves us. He loves us. He loves us. Let us love Him, or let us pray to Allah, oh Allah, let me to love You as much as You love me. Oh Allah, let me to be merciful to people as much You are merciful to me. Oh Allah, be kind. Let me to be kind to people as much as You kind to me. You can't. Because the kindness, the mercy, the compassion, the caring of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us is beyond imagination. We cannot use calculator. We cannot use any system to calculate His love, His care, and His compassion to all of us. No matter what we say, but what we need to say is, oh Allah, give me a part of Your wisdom, a part of Your love, a part of Your caring, a part of Your consideration to me, a part of Your forgiveness. This is it. So the love of Allah is translated in giving us the holy month of Ramadan, in giving us Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the teacher of humanity forever, in giving us the holy book of Quran, the guidance for humanity, and the book for eternity forever. Forever, forever, forever. See how much you are blessed in this month of Ramadan. See how much you are blessed in this month of Ramadan, and that every month, and every day, and every week, and every minute and every second, whenever we say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, with all these blessings, we have a duty to carry. We have a message to spread. Our duty is to stand up for the righthood for the men and women and creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To stand up for justice, to stand up for fairness, to stand up for consideration and looking after other people, and to be people's men and women through our love to the teacher of humanity and our submission to the creator of humanity, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our duty is a never-ending story. It's a never-ending story. It's a never-ending story. It's given to us by the man who refused to become a king, a lord, or become a prince, or become a wealthy man. And when the Qurayshites were trying to pressurize him in Mecca, to try to tell him, we'll give you wealth, we'll give you, we'll give you, we'll give you. He told his uncle, oh my uncle, wallahi, if they put the sun on my right hand and the moon in my left hand, but look at his hands, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here is the sun and here is the moon. To let me leave the religion of Allah, I will never ever do that. Tell one of two things will happen. Either I die before you, spreading the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or I will manage with your support, Allah, to spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was a challenge, and he accepted it, and he won. And he is still winning. He started as one man, with one woman, with one child, and with another man. And today, where are we now? 1.7 or 1.6 billion. Billion. In spite of the fact, all what have been said about him, all what have been said about Islam, or about Muslims as terrorists and radicals and extremists and. The more they attack Islam, the more people read about Islam. Because Islam is the deen of logic, the deen of reasoning, the deen of guidance, the deen of sharing and caring. No matter what they say and talk about yourself. September 11 came, attracted a lot of people. Salman Rushdie and Satanic Verses came, attracted a lot of people. Islamophobia is coming, attracted a lot of people. They call us extremists, terrorists, and people read. People read. Even you saw this young Italian, it was a hostage taken by people, terrorist organization in Somalia. I was watching the video when she came back. You know what she came back? She came back as a Muslim. Why? I don't know. You ask her. She read about Quran. She read about Islam while in captivity. And she became a Muslim. And she was in full hijab when she came back to Italy a few days ago or a week ago. So don't ever try to twist the arm of Islam. Because the arm of Islam is untwistable. Nobody can twist it. It's flexible, it accommodates, it guides, it teaches, it cares, it saves, and it empowers. The arm of Islam created many civilizations. For wherever we live in the past, we created civilization through the local community. This is our duty. Whether it was in Syria, nowadays, in Sham, in Iraq, in Egypt, in Turkey, in Andalusia, in Anadolia, all these great civilizations happened. I was reading something about the Renaissance of Andalusia and the civilization of Andalusia. The queen, when the fall down of Andalusia came, when actually Andalusia fall down, or what do you call it? You know, Isabella, the queen, the highly civilized, liberal, democratic, what did she do to the books of science, technology, and knowledge? She burned all of them. What a kind of hatred to humanity. What a kind of ignorance of science and technology that those people used to have. Some of the new scientists, you know what they said? They burned more than 1 million books. Exactly like the Mughal and the Tatar in Baghdad. They throw all the books of knowledge in Tigray River and the Euphrates River. Ignorance, hatred, and stupidity. With whatever left from the books of knowledge in Andalusia, about 30,000 books out of 1.5 million books being burned. This was the cornerstone of building the current civilization in the West. You know, from only 30,000 out of 1 million textbooks, science, astronomy, medicine, geography, agriculture, water, engineering, everything, music, arts, philosophy, literacy, everything, everything, everything. The scientists now in Europe, they are regretting this process of mad burning of the knowledge of society. And said, if we have this million book with us now in Europe or the whole world, we could have been building our houses, our villas, our life in the galaxies. In the galaxies. Because civilization and renaissance and development and achievement is a chain, a processing process of change, of chains of development, of achieving, of discovering, and of learning and teaching and yielding the knowledge to serve humanity, not yielding the knowledge to destroy humanity as we can see nowadays. Us people creating conflicts here and there to try to produce more weapons. This is what happened when Muslims build Renaissance and build civilization. Nowadays, this is our duty to bring it back, not to Muslims only, to everyone, anyone, everywhere, and anyone. Don't distinguish. Don't distinguish. Don't differentiate between Muslims and Muslims when it comes to helping, saving, caring, sharing. يطعمون الطعام على حبه مسكينا ويتيما واسيرا. They fed out of love the مسكين, the orphan, and the prisoner of war, the needy, the orphan. Allah سبحانه وتعالى did not say whether they are Muslims or not. You see the multi diverse, the multi dimensional, the multidimensional teaching of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the understanding of the ulama to the knowledge of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teaching of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam were the foundation of Renaissance, which saved humanity for centuries, guided humanity for centuries, and will save humanity, inshallah, for centuries by yourself. This is Ramadan. Our duty is to serve, save, and bend our back to help everybody and anybody. Our message also is not only to be delivered by a prophet or a messenger. It has to be delivered by each and every one of us, male and female, black and white, short and tall. The message of peace, salam, afshu salam, wa at'imu at'am, wa qumu bil-layl, wa an-nas yanam. Spread peace. Feed the people. Stand up at night while people are sleeping to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tadkhulu al-jannata bi-salam. So, by doing this, you will enter heaven peacefully to the highest level in al-Firdaus al-A'la. Afshu as-salam wa at'imu at'am wa qumu bil-layl wa an-nas yanam tadkhulu al-jannata bi-salam. Also, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam connected the poor to the first, the poverty to the first people to go to heaven. The poor people will enter heaven 500 years before the rich one. So I'm telling the rich one, rich people, be careful. Be careful with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given you. We have 820 million hungry folks in the whole world. 820, 21 or 22. Every second, an individual dies out of hunger. Every 5 seconds, a child dies out of hunger. Every year, about 36 or 33 million people die out of hunger. 6 of them are children, 6 million. And you have plenty of food to be wasted, plenty of drink and clean water to be wasted, plenty of resources to be wasted, plenty of waste to be wasted, and polluting the climate. And let us to be scared of an unseen soldier of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unseen, miserable. You cannot wait it and you cannot see it, but it kills to let the 7 or nearly 8 billion people to be looked down in their houses, scared of death from a little germ or a little miserable soldier of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودُ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. The only one who know the soldier of Allah is Allah. People nowadays standing up to say, who is Allah? Where is Allah? What's Allah? All this sort of thing. All this, what's the sort of thing? Allah is patience. Allah is kind. Allah give the zalimeen, the oppressors, the tyrants, chance once, twice, 5 times, 10 times, they might go back, because Allah is not a punisher. Allah is the mercy and the merciful and the kind and compassionate. He does not want people to go to hellfire. He wants everybody to go to heaven. But when they refuse and they insist to refuse and fight the status of Allah, he will treat them like pharaohs, like Nimrod and his people, and what happened to them. آمانا فرعون والنمرود إلى آخره إلى آخره إلى آخره. See? Sometimes we run out of patience. When we see what's happening in Yighur, in China. When you see what's happening in Kashmir, in India. When you see what's happening in Arakan, Burma, for Rohingya people. When you see what's happening in Yemen, to the innocent Yemeni people. The people. When you see what's happening in Syria, with the barrel bombs descending from hell on the innocent people. When you see what's happening to the people in different parts of the world, being tortured, killed, became destitute, became displaced, became, and we tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, we cannot take it anymore. It's too much, it's heavy. It's heavy. It's heavy to see the killing. It's heavy to see the zulm. It's heavy to see all this atrocity and tyranny. These lies, hypocrisy. Hypocrisy. But Allah yumhil wala yumhil. Allah delayed things to give people a chance to go back to Him. But does not ignore or forget. Never. And the Quran, which we see nowadays, is one of the soldiers of Allah. For the last, at least myself, for the last nearly 2.5 or 3 months, I am locked down in my house. When I go out, I go with hijab or I go with niqab. I was just joking with one of my friends, telling them, will niqab become the fashion of the 21st century to protect us from Corona, or the sisters of Corona, or the brothers of Corona, or the mutilated genes of Corona, and. Some of the benefits of Corona is closing now all the red areas. Because we cannot trust who is there. Also, the area of the devils, was in certain corners. People are scared to have this yani bad relationship between a man and a woman, or between a woman and a woman, or between a man and a man. We went so far in turning our back to Allah and telling him, okay, we don't need you. Astaghfirullah azim. Allah will tell you, okay, Corona, go. Corona comes. And now people talking about, wait a year or 2 years, nobody knows. Because no treatment and no vaccine has been developed. And we take it ourselves as a sign, of mercy. Because this will tell us, go back. Go back, especially in this month of Ramadan and at any other month, to the Lord of everything, to the Creator of everything, to the first and last, to the Alim and the Alim and the Alam al-Ghuyub, to the Mighty, to the Powerful, to the Able, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does Allah need us? No. At all. Does Allah deprive any non-believer from his kingdom? No. Does Allah deprive me, if I'm a kafir, from breathing, from having my food to be digested in my stomach, from my blood running in my body, from my head and my brain thinking, from me achieving, even while I'm achieving, I'm fighting and cursing him? He doesn't. He doesn't. And this is the wisdom. He fairly treats everybody in this life and does not deprive his enemies and the tyrant who created the tyrannies from living in this life. But when they go to him, he will put, subhanahu wa ta'ala, their acts and deeds on scale. Very, very scale. More sensitive than the scales, the micro, the electronic scales of nowadays. And we'll let each one of us to see his video, lifelong video, in the dark, what I used to do, what you people used to do, and in public, what we used to do. Nothing left, even the whispers, even the thinking, even the intention, which at my heart. So when he makes the judgment, He makes it fair. But in dunya, he never, ever, ever, ever deprive the people who fight Muslims and kill Muslims from the right to live comfortably where? In his kingdom. Eating his rizq, drinking his rizq, wearing his rizq, spending his rizq. All this, living in his rizq, which is the planet, or the houses and all this, so driving his rizq, which are the cars. See? This is the difference from a man-made God and Lord, and the Lord of the Lord, and the Creator of all the creation. If I was claimed to be a God, I will be driven by my desire. If I am the God, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, I'll be controlled by advices, wrong and right of some people. But the knowledgeable, the Creator, and the guide, and the wisdom is from Him, who knows everything, everything, even the little worm inside the big stone that nobody can see it. He provides her with rizq. With rizq. With rizq. This is how we are privileged, very much privileged, to follow the teaching of the teacher of humanity and the Lord of humanity and the Creator of humanity, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our message is spread peace. Then our mission don't stop, no matter what they talk about you, no matter how they treat you. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. Never stop. The more they block your way to guide people, the more you become a resilience to help everybody and anybody. I mean it, everybody and anybody. Everybody and anybody. Don't stop helping. Don't stop reaching. Don't stop delivering the act of goodness to anyone. Don't ever ask about their religion, their culture, their language. A human being is a human being. An animal has to be respected as well. A bird, a woman locked in, a cat. Neither she fed her, nor she provided her with some drink. She went to hellfire, wa'ayyazu billah. A prostitute from the Israelites, when she was passing by a panting dog, she took her food, shoes off and went to the well and brought some water for her. Allah forgive her for this noble act. Teacher who teaches humanity, like a lot of teachers amongst you, is following the teaching of the prophets of God. Because prophets were teachers, messengers were teachers, and teachers are taking a part of the prophetical message of the messengers and prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All this, who will talk about Corona? The white army, more impressive than the military one. The nurses, the auxiliary, the sisters, the staff nurses, the cleaners in the hospital, who are dying every day, everywhere in the hospital, serving and serving you and me when I am suffering from Corona. A new heavenly profession that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in their hearts, the mercy and the kindness. Whether those people are Muslims or non-Muslims, they stand with open heart to see and meet the unseen enemy, which is called the coronavirus. Many of them are dead nowadays. So what we need from you, brothers, is to keep sharing. Sharing what you have. Don't stop sharing. Don't stop helping. Don't stop guiding. Don't stop educating and teaching and advising. And in the month of Ramadan, it is the month of charity as well. Prophet ﷺ was the most generous, and he was extremely generous in his life, but most generous in Ramadan. Most generous in Ramadan. Please give. Give all the mosques, all the charities, all the community centers, all the small organizations, everybody. Please build bridges. Build bridges between you and others, whether the others will be Muslims or non-Muslims. In our country, South Africa, in our country, everywhere. South Africa for me is a very dear country. I love it. And I hope that you can love my South Africa like I love it. I don't have the passport, but I have the heart of South Africa here. Can you see it? I'm carrying it. I love all of you. But I love you to stand up, shining from the south. And the sun of the south to be shining the whole north, and the whole east, and the whole west. I was very impressed by you when I met young, talented, zealous, dedicated, committed, energetic, motivated, empowered South African young men and women. I wish I was living with you, because life with you is the life that I would like to do. Life with you is the life as well I would love to do or to live. So thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He given us, and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His privilege, and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His wisdom to us, and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from what He prevented us from having, in spite of the fact that it was our desire to have it, because we don't know His knowledge. Keep thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all having all these blessings from Him. See, I'll conclude by talking about you in South Africa, or in the West, or in the North, or in the East, or in the South, whatever it is. Once upon a time, a wise man called Muhammad, his people used to call him a magician, a poet, okay? But he was a wise man. He did not talk out of his nonsense. He was guided by the guidance of the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This wise young man, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting in the shade of Kaaba. And he was looking at the skies, and the moon, and the stars, and imagining, visualizing whom he will meet and whom he'd like to see. He was talking about you, each and every one of you, in this flat, or in this house, or in this villa, or in this mansion, on the street, or in the car, listening. He said to his companions, إنني في شوق لأحبابي اشتاق شوق الحبيب لمحبوبي. The desire of the beloved one to the people that he loves. Desire, here. You know, when you put your hand on your heart and you feel this satisfaction, this tranquility. The companion told them, aren't to be your beloved one? He said, no, it's not you. It's you. It's you. It's you. He was talking about you. Here and there, in every township, in every street, in every corner, it's you. His love, he was talking about you. And he told them, the act of each one of you is equivalent to the act of each 50 of you. You know what are the 50? Sahaba. You know why? Because he knew from his wisdom and the guided knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will be suffering and tortured badly by the surrounding philosophical climate. As he said in one hadith, the time will come upon you that the one who is trying to stick himself or herself to the religion will be like the one will be holding in his hand or her hand a burning fire. But he will take it because he wants to receive the deen. And he, in another hadith, said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, تتكالب عليكم الأمم كما تكالب الأكرد على قصاده. The different ummah, different nations will run on you. Like the hungry men and women running to the big meal and big dish. And the companion of the Prophet ﷺ told him, is that because we are few? He said, no, not few. You are plenty. 1.7 billion. ولكنكم غثاء كغثاء. But you will become like this frothy, creamy layer on the wave, in the sea and in the ocean. Which is the wave will take it this way. Because we have no shape, no weight, no taste. وَلَنْزَعَنَّ اللَّهُ الْمَهَابَةَ مِنْ قُلُوبِ عَدُوِيكُمْ. And Allah will take off the fear of your enemy from you. And He will throw in your heart something called الْوَهَن. They told him, what is الْوَهَن, your Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? Said, حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا وَكَرَيَةَ الْمَا. The last point to discuss is love of dunya and fear of death. Because we have the wahn in our hearts, we became what we are nowadays. But if we have the iman in our hearts in Ramadan and beyond Ramadan, we'll never become like what we're unhappy, what we're seeing today. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. And I conclude by saying to each one of you, the one who lives for himself or herself only lives there or live their timely life. But the ones who live for others live forever. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you amongst those people who live for others, so they can live forever and they can serve everybody. I love you, South Africa. I love you anywhere and everywhere, wherever you are. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And thank you, Islamic Youth South Africa, for allowing me to communicate and talk with you and your people in South Africa, in Johannesburg, in Durban, in Cape Town, and in everywhere. I love you, Africa, and I love you, South Africa. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.